What is that we should be doing to address cybersecurity? How is the task of securing our systems is going to be addressed by us? What are the things that are available to us? So one way you can reduce vulnerability is by basically following some design principles that are good for security. And when they're more secure, there are fewer vulnerabilities and less likely to be compromised. So complexity is always the enemy. There are well-established studies that show whether it's bugs or performance-related things or whatever it is, those increase with the complexity or size of lines of code, for example. So one way to reduce vulnerabilities is what we call this economy of mechanism. Should be a small set of mechanisms that your system fundamentally relies on. So avoid complexity, keep it simple, keep it small. Chances are that you're going to have fewer vulnerabilities added. Another design principle is fail-safe defaults. Fail-safe defaults always say when somebody may or may not need access to some sensitive data, you deny it. If they really need it, at that point you can allow it. So default should be denied. And fail-safe default is that the thing is protected, access is controlled. Complete mediation says your system should never allow someone to bypass that monitor. The monitor has to mediate before someone is able to gain access to the resource. The idea is that someone who's there to enforce that accesses are those allowed by policy you have in place, then you can't bypass it, and that's the complete mediation requirement. A lot of people don't believe that you can get security by obscurity. So if someone says, well, we are secure because no one knows how we do something, well, don't count on that. Perhaps somebody smart can reverse engineer and learn most of it. So open design is good because we're not counting on somebody not finding out how we do things. An extremely important design principle is what's called least privilege. So in systems at any time, essentially when you're running an application or a program, you have the privilege to be able to access a set of resources. Least privilege says you should only have privileges for resources that you absolutely need and nothing more. It's a damage containment idea. If something were to go wrong, what you can harm is the set of resources for which you hold privileges. We said people are the weak link when it comes to security, and that is because we perhaps expect people to do something that doesn't come naturally to them. So psychological acceptability says, don't ask people to do that, doesn't put excessive burden on them. So there are a number of these design principles. Actually, they come from a classical paper that's called Design Principles for Secure Systems. You'll have a link to that paper. At least read the design principles section out of that paper. And for each of these principles, we should understand how does it enhance or improve cybersecurity